So welcome back, third and last video, at least for now, on the Peak Design tripod. I might in a few weeks make another one just to tell you what I think about after using it for a while, but I have not seen many people having all the parts, so I figured since I own all of them now, that I also will show you them and give a tiny bit more feedback. So if you watched the two previous ones, you can still see we are in the small conversion kit sort of setup, because otherwise I could not put it on the table with the top camera. You can see it already almost hit already. So let's take it out, and you can see that if you have not seen the previous one where we talk about, for example, the doesn't support my L brackets, etc., that clearly it supports this L bracket because it's in there, combined with the locking mechanism, which works. I noticed that my autofocus on that lens, on that camera, is a little bit too aggressive. Sorry about that. And it's also a little bit too wide, so let me turn it back a tiny bit. Oops, all the way around. So, yeah, so what we will do is I want to show you the different parts. So first one, let me take the current part out, which is the normal head. Normally it would sink in, right? So you, the whole idea is that you have it in a, you can open it up, and then if you have it in the correct sort of position, it totally hides away, and that's how you transport it. And you can also, by the way, use it like this, but that's the idea. And but you can remove this and you can see you have this sort of part. Now, one thing what you can buy extra, and it was about $25, is an extra plate, which I can't show you in the original form anymore because I already connected up something. So let me open it up a little bit, and I on purpose put a really small one on there because I think it's a travel solution, which already gave me one sort of small detail and a problem. But you can see that you can get this, so let's still need to learn this a little bit, sorry about that. So if you please subscribe, you want to subscribe. If you have questions about the Sony full frame cameras, go to our Facebook group. There are about 15,000 people now. Yeah, we answer questions about setup tips and related items, so probably also post this there. So the universal head adapter is basically what you see here, and you can see it's the same sort of part, but then with just a flat surface, so that you can either put your own ball head on there, or you can put a video head on there. Now the video head I put on there, it looks now a bit weird, because if you basically put it all in, you can see that it's quite small, which I think fits with the whole travel idea. And you open it up, so let me open it up completely. It's always a little bit tricky because I never know how to do it with this one, but there is a trick to it. If I open up this one like this, then this one I have to open up completely, and then you can sort of put it over there and then put it back. And you can see it turns into a video head. Now, trust me, it's not the best video head ever. Of course, you lock this up again and you can put this in the position where it needs to be in the correct position, like this. And you can use it. Might even fit in here. Yeah, it does. So let me put it in here a tiny bit up and rotate it around, and you can see, of course, I need to open it up a little bit. You can see that this is for travel, or if you want to use it as that, because it's again a 1.2 kilograms solution, that this might be one that you want to use. Now, one thing you notice, and I'm not sure if you can see it on the top view, no, is that the screws that they supply are already, I think it does not make sense to put a really big video head on there. So I would have loved if they put the screws which are in there a little bit closer to each other. But you can see it is working. Yeah, and you can use it. So that's the first part I wanted to show you. And of course, yeah, you can also put the big part on there again, and yeah, then you're done. So let me put this aside. Let's put it back here again, And yeah, look at the second part that I ordered, which is the ultra light conversion kit. And this is actually quite fun because we can for the first time try to put it in an original position. So let me first get it and so one thing I really like is that as far as I can see, all the parts are quite easy to maintain yourself, which is not always the case. So all the screws, and especially if you see the legs later on, it's clear that you can take them apart, and you might actually have to because they might loosen up over time and stuff like that. But I actually kind of like you can maintain it, and that they already put manuals online on how to do it. But you can see that I've now used it in this light conversion mode, where it's only about 700 grams. You can take these out, so you can see there are buttons here, and I can even use the top camera now, which is cool. And I've not done this before, but I'm assuming if I press this button, then I can take it out. That would be fun. Yeah, that makes perfect sense and works. So let me all take all three out. And there you can see the inside of the carbon. So then they have these the three legs, and you can see that that's what I mean with all these screws. It's quite easy to take them apart and clean it if you want. So that's kind of nice. But you can see the four flaps, which you normally use to let me only do one of them to extend the legs. But there's a fifth one, which is a tiny bit bigger. And if you open up that one, you can see that it sort of has a different mechanism. And that's actually the way that you can sort of put it into the whole leg. Again, this is the first time. So, whoops, by mistake, I hit my video switcher. So I turned something on. What did I turn on? Let me put it in this way. So I have to be careful a tiny bit. Well, it works quite well. You can shift it in. I'm assuming you should be able then maybe I should have done this before. There might be a trick to this. Let me try it on another leg and a little bit closer to my body so that I can see what I'm doing. Why would you do this the first time on video? Maybe I also need to take the second. Yeah, you need to also open up the second one, I think. And then it slides in quite easy. Let me put it on this one. And then you close up this one, and I guess also this one. And this one goes further over the leg, as you can see. And it closes up like this. And now it's in its normal position again. We'll check later on if I did it correctly, but I think it's on correctly. So let's do the second leg. I'm assuming now I have to open up both of them. So the big one and the second one, and then slide it in carefully. Yeah, see, and then you can see that the holes line up, and it also feels that it's in the correct position. Lock up this one and lock up, let's say, the one for the main leg, and it looks fine again. Let me check if this one is also working. Yeah, so it feels, I wouldn't say clumsy would be the wrong word, but it feels that you can take it apart, which gives you this Lego-like feeling. But it also means that it's quite easy to clean and to maintain or to replace a part, which is not always true with some of these tripods. So third leg, let's put that back in this normal position. Third leg, I heard that you have to be careful. If I check the manual, you can also quite nicely see the design, right? So you can see the different carbon parts sort of all together. I think you have to be careful that you don't lose this part. So I'm not sure if you can get it off, but if I remember correctly, they warn you about this. But of course, I watched one time the video and then I didn't check the manual. So open up these two, slide it back in. Yeah, it goes quite easy. So I'm assuming that this is the way that you do it. Open up this part again. Yeah, and all three of them are now in its original position again. Cool. So let me also put the normal head back on and the center column. So first the head. Let me put it on this camera. And that goes like this, which you can't see at the moment. It's a pity for you. Oh, now I do remember that you, and I will show you how that works. And of course, I didn't get the tool, but we have a little bit of a bag here, and there should be a tool in there. So with some of these accessories, they give you this bag. And there should be a tool in there. And I think this is probably also one of the sizes that will work for this, I hope. Because if you rotate the head, there's a manual online that you can follow. But if you open up this mechanism, you'll find that there is a hole over there. You can see it. And I'm sort of assuming that this will fit. But this is the wrong size. Could be the wrong size. But I also put the other one in here, which is normally attached to the leg. I did not do that. I don't want that, so, but I'm pretty sure that this one will fit. Yes. So, oh, it's already open, of course, in this case, so that makes perfect sense. So what you can do is you slide in this part. I'm assuming like this, and then close it up again. That should be okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. They were talking about 6 or 7 twists, I guess. Already feel it, so I opened it up a little bit too much, I guess. But I feel it sort of grabbing, and it's now. You don't over tighten it, so it's now locked in again, and you can see that we have a complete tripod again. So I will put it in this lower position so that you can see. Well, I can't of course put it in totally in this lower position, that was the reason why I did it. So let me zoom this one out. I'm not sure what we will see then, but you can kind of see part of the video setup, sorry for that, but you can see that it's now sort of in its totally combined setup again. So if you look at the other camera, you'll see that if we put it down, that this is now complete again. Of course, if you want to put it in its normal position when you are want to travel, you have to put it in a correct place. This lock goes in and out, and now it's totally ready for travel. And this, of course, what we were talking about, how small it is, and that I can almost reach it around completely with my hand, but I measured it in the fattest part. So yeah, the last part that I got with it is the spikes, which are probably in another small bag in the bag. So let me put this tool back, which normally would be hidden on one of the legs, but I've decided not to put it there. As a personal thing, I always have tools in my bag anyway, so I didn't want it. Now the spikes I'm just going to show you, because I'm not going to put them on. It's too much work for now. But you can see at the bottom that there are these rubber nails, and you can get these small spikes, which feel quite nice, to be fair. And you can just take these out and put these spikes on there. There's a manual on there. They will look a little bit like this. And from the top view, it will look a tiny bit like this once you put them in. And of course these rubbers will be away then, and this will replace them. There are three extra screws in the back, but there are also three screws here, so I guess you have three extra screws if needed. I'm pretty sure you're supposed to leave them in the rubber, but you can see there are three screws, and these look kind of like normal screws that I have quite many of. So you're not supposed to lose them, but if you lose them, it's probably not the biggest thing in the world. And it comes in its own small bag. And what I've done is that I basically, just to make sure that they don't lose the screws, I sort of put it like this and then put the string over it so that it doesn't, can't go anywhere. And then I put it in the other bag. So these are basically the extra parts that come with the Peak Design tripod. Yeah, next thing is I will give you feedback of how it was in use. So hopefully it will have a long and prosperous life. I think I probably need to register to get the lifetime warranty. And I'll tell you, if it does what it is supposed to be doing. So again, it's not cheap, it's not overly expensive compared to some of the other solutions. And for me, it seems to be, at least my first feeling is that it's doing what they claim it does, which is, that's important, right? I mean, can it go even further in? No, this is about it. So it can still move even if it's in its lower position, or is one of them lower than the other ones? No, you can still move it a tiny bit. Oh, sorry, you could not see that. I was wondering because you can still move it a bit, as you can see, if you open it up. Oh no, there is one position where it's closed down better. So yeah, that's about it. Sorry for the long videos, but that's how what I am and what I do. So hopefully it was somewhat useful for you, and see you in the next one. Bye bye.